Hey guys, what is going on? This is Acid Glow here. Now, I got some hardcore kill confirmed gameplay, and this is one of my really good gameplays because I go 51 kills and 5 deaths, and I made a slight change to my score streaks this time. So, normally what I always ran was UAV, Hunter Killer, and the Hellstorm. However, I thought I would try my luck with a turret. Now, normally when I play the other Call of Duty games, I was never a fan of the turret. Simply because of the spawning system. Depending on what location you put the turret on, and depending if you choose to move it around afterwards, it might benefit you and it might not. Like for example, the first turret I put was at the back of the barn, and the reason I put it there is because there is a huge gap of having to run to it to get behind it to shoot it. So the only way they can actually take down the turret is by having multiple enemies charge it at once so it gets distracted while the other players shoot it. Or if you can find a slight angle where the turret is missing its shots, or if the enemy happens to use a hacking device like the Black Hat or an EMP grenade. They can also use the Hunter Killer and the Hellstorm. For example, some killstreaks will actually blow it up. Now, fortunately for me in this match, people were not really running any of those things, so I was actually free to use as many sentry guns as I could. Now, however, when you get the sentry guns, I find the best places to put them in standoff is close to the spawn location. Now, one of the spawn locations is, of course, near the barn, and the reason I put it there is because, like I said, there's a huge gap, and it takes them quite a while to get it a really good angle from that position, because it covers a huge arc from where they spawn. Now, the other thing is, if they happen to spawn near it, it actually covers a pretty huge gap between the gas station and to the right side of the street where that big warehouse is. Now, the other thing is, I can put it on the other spawn location, which is located near the haystacks. I'm actually going close to it. Right after you go to this building, you make a left. This is the other spawn location. So this is another spot I put it in because I like to go back and forth. Normally what I think some people like to do is they like to kind of just defend half of the map and just wait for the opposing enemy to kind of charge them, and they'll just pick them off, you know, halfway through the map. However, when I'm using the turret, I kind of like to force the spawns to switch to the other side. So the enemies would then actually get shot by my turret as they're, you know, unexpectedly spawning and they're running across the open street between the barn, the warehouse, and the gas station. The same goes for the turret placement I put down outside the street here, which covers the barn and the side of the house on the right side. So the other thing is, I find the turret is kind of all right. I don't really tend to actually have to manually control it because I really don't think it's necessary, because it's one of those score streaks where you kind of just throw it and kind of forget. You know, very similar to the Hunter Killer, pretty much. I find that I don't really get around to kind of changing the placement of a turret that is already placed somewhere. I kind of just put it somewhere kind of that has an advantage point for the enemies. So when they actually spawn near it, they'll get shot by it. I don't really think they'll spawn in front of it, because the way the spawning system is, I think kind of pushes you away from any kind of score streaks that can possibly spawn kill you. So with that being said, that's why I kind of put it on a certain angle there. Now I'm going to show you a short little picture showing the top view of the four different placements that I put all four of my turrets during this match. Alright, so the red dots are the turrets themselves, and these are the actual locations I put them in the map. And the green little markers are showing the angles they can cover from those locations. So I like specifically put them on those angles to kind of gain an advantage from anyone who's walking down the middle of the street in a wide open area where they have very little cover. However, if you look at the one in the bottom left corner near the barn, there are some haystacks that can give you some cover, as well as the bottom right, there's a tank as well. And the top right, there's a tank there as well. But for the majority, I think it kind of worked out for the most part, because I think there were a lot of spots where people kind of tended to run in down middle of the street or across the tanks, across the barn, and they just didn't expect a turret to be there. However, I think I lost one turret, one or two turrets, something like that. I believe it was just one during the entire match. So at most of the time I had two of them functional at the same time. So generally speaking, I think the turret is kind of all right. However, if you play a couple of matches with the same lobby, I think they're going to pick up that you kind of like to use the turret. So they're probably going to equip the EMP grenade or the black hat. And by then you actually might have to change your score streaks up a bit. So the thing is, it might not work in every single lobby, but I think those are some key points to using the turret pretty effectively. You know, just finding a huge open area and pretty much push it up against the wall or the corner as much as you can, so the enemy does not have the option of running up and going behind the turret so they can safely shoot it down. So this way they're forced to go into the open and maybe shoot it down with bullets or throw an EMP grenade from a distance or over a little ledge or even hack it through a wall if they have the engineer perk on. So anyways, I kind of liked the turret because I thought it would be a time to kind of change up a little bit. I am a fan of the Lodestar, which is pretty much the equivalent score streak of the Reaper from Modern Warfare 3. However, I do not get it that often, or I'd say even at all. I think it's because I'm playing hardcore and you die extremely fast, and it's very risky running down the center of the street, you know, trying to capture three tags when people could be like sniping you or just waiting for you to walk down the street, just baiting you to go there so they can shoot you down. So the thing is, I'm mostly just using the shorter score streaks, and I find the turret is kind of all right. You know, in replace of the Hunter Killer, which normally just gets me one kill, I'd say about maybe 80% of the time, because there are situations when the Hunter Killer just seems to kind of charge at an enemy, but they get into cover just in time, and then it's a wasted score streak. Like, it doesn't get me a single kill. So I think for now I'll be using the turret, and I kind of tried the Guardian a little bit. You know, there are some situations when you can use the Guardian alongside the turret, and you can kind of use the Guardian to kind of guard the turret so no one can actually get close to it, or you can use both together and kind of block off two entrances, which is not too bad. But for the most part, I think I'd rather have just a turret and have multiple turrets across the map rather than combine it with the Guardian. I don't think the Guardian is really that good because it's got very short range and it's got this kind of sparkling effect that kind of gives it away, that's kind of, you know, aiming down this one area. So the team that we were facing was actually trying to get towards all my turrets. So the one near the barn, I kind of tended to stay near it when I spawned there, or when I spawned away, I kind of ran over there because I want to save them because they're doing such a really efficient job at getting me some free kills and free points pretty much. So I just want to know, whenever you get kills with a score streak, it does give you a kill. However, you get less amount of points for that. So, you know, just keep that in mind if you're thinking, okay, I can use this and rack up a bunch of points, which doesn't really work all the time. You know, it's got to get more kills because you get less points with a score streak. So that was my turret gameplay. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you later.